Namaste, my dear friends. A lot of people come to me now and they ask me a very funny question. They ask me, sir, I have been doing yoga for many years. When is the right time to start meditation? And sometimes I laugh to myself because yoga is actually meditation. And I don't blame any of these students for their naivety, because it is the responsibility of us as yoga teachers to guide people very well. Most yoga teachers in the world are themselves unaware of the differences between yoga as an exercise and yoga as a personal and spiritual evolution process. Most people practice exercise and call it yoga. That's why there is this confusion that yoga is different from meditation. There are many traditions of yoga that are focused on asanas exclusively, and they are unable to guide their students in deeper practices like meditation. And that's why many of these yoga practitioners, they come to these yoga schools, or rather asana schools, and also search for meditation through other techniques like the Zen meditation techniques or mindfulness meditation techniques or other forms of meditation techniques. That's a sad reality, because yoga is a tradition very rich with meditation. When you go to the classical source texts of yoga, like the Patanjali's Yoga Sutra, the entire third and fourth chapters are focused very strongly on meditation. In fact, that is considered to be the most important tool in yoga. So that's why it's a bit sad to see the state of yoga today around the world, and even yoga bodies that are trying to regulate yoga and yoga therapy actually are trying to keep yoga and keep the understanding of yoga as basically physical exercises, and that's a very sad state of affairs. Yoga must include all the aspects of yoga, and meditation is central to yoga, and meditation is yoga. Just take a moment to reflect on this, my friends. In the old days, when yogis were practicing asana, they were normally doing it statically. And what were they doing in the static asanas? They were not just simply sitting, they were regulating the breath, which means they were doing pranayama in asana. So when you take that they are doing pranayama in asana, every asana becomes pranayama. Now what were they doing in pranayama? They were doing pranayama where they would regulate the breath with certain breath specific ratios. Inhale equals exhale, or inhale is half of exhale, or rather exhale is double of inhale, etc. How did they manage to count the duration? They did not have clocks to measure seconds. They were using mantra. So when they were inhaling, they would recite a mantra mentally. When they would exhale, they would recite the same mantra mentally. That would become equal inhale, equal exhale. The same way when they had to do double exhale to the inhale, they would recite the mantra on inhale and they would recite the mantra two times on exhale. So this way, every pranayama became a mental exercise as well, and there was the integration of body through the asana, breath through the breathing technique, and mind through the mantra, which represented a certain focus. So therefore the asana became a pranayama, became meditation or dhyanam. Now this is because each mantra represents different focuses. So if you chose the sun mantra and repeated it many times, it became the meditation of the sun. If you chose the moon mantra and repeated many times, it would become the meditation of the moon. So this is one of the forms of meditation that yoga is talking about. But there are many other forms of meditation as well that is part of the rich yoga tradition. And I would certainly encourage you all to move towards this direction of yoga as meditation, and therefore seek yoga schools and yoga teachers that are not teaching yoga merely as asana practices, but are able to offer the more diverse and in-depth profound teachings of yoga, especially yoga as a meditative experience. Yoga is fundamentally about the mind, my friends. That is why Patanjali defines yoga as chitta vritti nirodha. Patanjali does not define yoga as a body practice. Please don't forget this. And I invite you all to take a step forward and go into yoga as a meditative experience so that you could expand the potential of your mind and become the extraordinary beings that each of you are. Namaste, my friends.